Good morning, students. Today we are going to see a new topic, chapter 7 from volume 2, matrices and data building. Okay, so matrices, you might hear this word in 10th standard, even in 9th standard. So basically, you know what is matrices. Okay, so matrices is nothing but just a rectangular array. You know how it came? We'll see how the matrices is formed. Okay, let me take if you are going to have 10 pens and 5 notebooks. Okay, so first we are just having 10 pens. Okay, 10 pens and 5 notebooks, that is you are having. Okay, next, and your friend, let them be F1, friend 1 is having 5 notebooks and 12 pens, right? And next is your friend 2, and another one friend is having 11, okay, let it be a simple 4 notebooks, pens and 15 notebooks. Okay, see, you have a data, that is you have 10 pens and 5 notebooks, and your friend 1 is having 5 pens and 12 notebooks, another friend is having 4 pens and 15 notebooks. Okay, so you have given the data and you have to arrange this data in some way. Okay, so in some form within the square bracket. I have arranged the data in some form within a square bracket. And this arrangement is nothing but matrix. This arrangement is nothing but matrix. Right? So matrix is just an arrangement of elements or entries. That is the thing which I have written inside. See, this is an element. Okay, we call this as an element or entries. So everything which is inside a square bracket are called element or entries. So just an arrangement of elements within a square bracket are called matrices. And here we are arranging rows and columns. That is, the horizontal representation is called row. The horizontal representation is called row. And the vertical representation is called column. Okay? So the vertical representation is called column and the horizontal representation is called row. Here I have 1, 2, 3 rows and 1, 2 columns. Okay? So I have 3 rows. I have 3 rows and 2 columns. Okay, so I have 3 rows and 2 columns. By this, I can define the order of this matrix as 3 by 2. Okay, so by this, I am defining the what? The order of this matrix as 3 by 2. Where rows comes first and columns comes second. Always rows comes first and column comes second. Okay, so this is nothing but the order of a matrix. We read this order as 3 by 2. Okay, so this is a matrix of order 3 by 2. Okay, and the elements, the numbers which is inside are called elements. The elements may be of any type. It may be of a constants, variables, or algebraic expressions, whatever may be. Okay, even a trigonometric exponential terms can also accommodate this bracket. And that arrangement is called matrix. And matrix is simply defined as a rectangular array or arrangement of elements in rows and columns within a square bracket. Okay? Next, we are going to see the general form of a matrix. Okay? So, you know, the matrix is just a rectangular array. Now, we are just going to see the general form of a matrix. Okay? If a matrix A has m rows, okay, the matrix is having m rows and n columns, then it is written as A of Aij m cross n, where I takes the values from 1 to m and j takes the values from 1 to n. So this is the general representation, okay? Whereas we always used to mention a matrix only in capital letter, but the elements are being represented in small letters, okay? So and j. I am going to give you an example. See, instead of m, I am going to take 3, and instead of n, I am going to take 4. Okay. So the number of rows is 3 here, and number of columns is 4 here. So we are going to make a matrix of order 3 by 4. Okay. So let me write the matrix of 3 by 4. Here, my matrix is A. So first, I am going to give 1. Instead of I takes values from 1 to m. So instead of m, I am going to take 3. So it takes the value 1, 2, and 3. So the number of rows is 3 here. So first element is A1, and here my column is 4. So 1, 1. Next is first row, second element. Next is first row, third element. First row, fourth element. Okay. Next is second row, first element. It is second row, first column. Second row, second column. Second row, third column. Second row, fourth column. Next is third row, first column. Third row, second column. Third row, third column. And third row, fourth column. So likewise, we write the general matrix. Okay. So this is the general representation of a matrix of order 3 by 4. And you can write whatever form, okay, in whatever order you can give a matrix. So this is the general form, where n is number of rows and n is number of columns. And you have to be very clear that the first term has to be 1, and it can go till m for row. And for column also, it starts from 1 and goes to n. Okay. So this is an example of a matrix of order 3×2. And this is the general form. Here, the matrix is represented in capital letter, and the elements are represented in small letters, whereas the numbers represents the place of that element. That is first row, first column, and this is second row, third column, and here this is third row, fourth column. The number represents the place of the element. Next, we are going to see types of matrices. Okay, so you all learn. You will learn that addition of a matrix, subtraction of a matrix, and multiplication of a matrix in 10th standard. And you might learn some of the types of a matrix also. Okay. Now we are just going to see those types in detail. Okay. Now first is row matrix. First is row matrix. That is a matrix having only one row is called row matrix. And generally we represent a row matrix as A equal to Aij of 1×n. So it is generally represented as A is equal to Aij 1×n. Okay. 1 represents the number of rows, and n represents the number of columns. The column may be different. Okay. It can take values from 1 to n. It might be of any number. Okay. So but the number of rows must be 1. That is called row matrix. And you can give an example. That is A is equal to C 1, 2, pi and minus 3. This is an example for this is of order 1 by 4. Okay. So this is a good example of the row matrix. See, I have taken positive number, pi, and negative number. So the element in the matrix can differ. Here my matrix will be of the form that is every element, okay, every element of a matrix is going to be zero. Okay, so this is of a matrix 3×3 and it can be of an order anything, but simply write this as zero matrix in this form. Just input only one zero to represent the zero matrix. Okay, and it means the elements of the matrix is all equal to zero. And this zero matrix has some other name that is nothing but null matrix. Null matrix. You all hear this word? Null matrix, void matrix. So, null matrix or void matrix, you might hear this word in some corpus that is null void. I know you have recollected the name, that is Kelvin, null void, okay? Nothing but zero, okay? Null and void, both means this word zero, okay? Next is square matrix. So here, the number of row is equal to number of column, okay? The number of row is equal to number of column. Then the matrix is said to be a square matrix. So here, see, this is the best example of a square matrix because the number of row is 3 and number of column is 3. If number of rows and columns are going to be equal, then the matrix is said to be a square matrix, okay? So the example of this can be of this form also. Yeah, this is a zero matrix. We can give another example that is e power x, log x, 1, minus 2, 3, 0, cos x, pi, and some other, maybe of a fraction even. Okay? So this is an example of a square matrix. Here the order is 3×3. The number of rows is equal to number of columns. Okay, so this is an example for square matrix. Then we are going for diagonal matrix. So diagonal matrix must be a square matrix first. Okay? So we can define the diagonal matrix only if the matrix is a square matrix. That is, here the element of the matrix, that is, see, a square matrix A of Aij is called a diagonal matrix if Aij is equal to 0 whenever I is not equal to j. That is, I is row, isn't it? I is row and j is column. And you all know this is A11, this is A12, this is A13, this is A21, this is A22, this is A23, and again A31, A32, A33. Right? So, by definition, these terms, right? These terms will become 0 because when Aij is equal to 0, whenever I is not equal to j. See, here I is 1, j is 2. So this term will become 0 and this also will become 0. Here it is 0, this is also 0, this is also 0. So from this, it means I have values only in my diagonal. So that is why the name of this matrix is called diagonal matrix. And the element may differ, okay? So this is called diagonal matrix. And next is scalar matrix, okay? So scalar is also a diagonal matrix. Scalar matrix is also a diagonal matrix. You all know if it is going to be a diagonal matrix, it must be a square matrix, right? So it is going to be a square matrix, a diagonal matrix where this A11 is equal to A22, is equal to A33. And if it is of order again, it is going to be 4. Yeah. So all those elements has to be a same element. If I take 2 here, this is also going to be 2. This is also going to be 2, this is also going to be 2. If I am going to take a root 2, right? So all the values of A11, A22, A33 and An will take the same value as such of root 2. So this type of matrix is called a scalar matrix, okay? So there is a difference between a diagonal and scalar matrix. In diagonal matrix, the element may differ. Here I can have 1. See, here I can have 1, here I can have 2, here I can have 3, here I can have 2, whatever, the number may differ in diagonal matrix, but in case of a scalar matrix, the terms have to be equal. people. And that is, they have mentioned the diagonal matrix whose entries along the diagonals are equal is called a scalar matrix. And this diagonal is nothing but a leading diagonal or principal diagonal. Okay, this, the name of this diagonal is nothing but leading diagonal or principal diagonal. The next type which we are going to see is unit matrix. So unit matrix is nothing but a diagonal matrix. Yes, it is similar to a scalar matrix. You all know what a scalar matrix. That is the element in the place of A11, A22, A33, etc. ANN are equal. Okay. So here, in case of unit matrix, see from the definition itself, we can understand this is a diagonal matrix because I not equal to J. When Aij is equal to 0, if I is not equal to J, so this is a diagonal matrix. And see, whenever I is equal to J, that means A11, A22, A33 and etc. ANN, the value of the Aij is nothing but 1. So it is going to be a matrix of the type like this. Here 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. This is of a matrix of order 3 by 3. Okay, so if the values in the leading diagonal is always 1, then the matrix is said to be a unit matrix. Okay, so this is what we call as a unit matrix. Then our elements in the leading diagonal is always equal to 1, which is of any order. Okay, here I have taken 3 by 3 and the remaining elements all will be equal to 0. This is similar to a scalar matrix, but in scalar matrix the values has, the value can be of anything, but the values has to be equal. That's it. But here it is fixed. The value has to be 1. Okay? So this is the definition of a unit matrix. Then we'll go for upper diagonal matrix. Okay? Upper diagonal matrix. The name itself says the values will be in the form of a triangle shape. Okay? That is a square matrix. See, this all has to be of only a square matrix. That is, the number of rows must be equal to number of columns. Okay? A square matrix is said to be a upper triangular matrix if the elements below the leading diagonals are 0. So here, the elements in the below the leading diagonals, see, I am going to take a simple example of 3 cross 3. See, I am going to take here 1. This is pi, this is root 3, and here it is going to be 0. Here I am going to take minus 2, this is 4, and here it is going to be 0, this is also 0, and this is minus 1. See, this is my leading diagonal, right? This is my leading diagonal, and the elements below the leading diagonal is all equal to 0. So the matrix of the form, see, this is of order 3 by 3. So this is of a matrix, an example for it, upper triangle matrix. Here the values below the leading diagonals are always equal to 0. Okay, but the values above the leading diagonal may be, then you can have any sorts of numbers. Okay, so this is an example of what, upper triangle matrix. Next we are going to see lower triangle matrix. So obviously you will be very clear with this. I'm relating to upper triangle. So the lower triangle must have 1, 0, 0 above the leading diagonal. That's it. Okay. So here the square matrix is said to be a lower triangle matrix if the elements above the leading diagonals are 0. That is, here the elements on the leading diagonal, see, I'm going to take the same example that A is equal to, see, this is always capital letter, 1, minus 2, minus 1. So I am taking my pi here and root 3 here, and here I am just taking 4, and this becomes 0, 0, 0. Okay. See, now the element above the leading diagonals are equal to 0. Right? The element above the leading diagonals are equal to 0. So this matrix is said to be a lower triangle matrix. That is, I have a diagonal below the leading diagonal. Okay. And next is triangular matrix. Either upper or lower triangle, any triangular matrix is all. always said to be a diagonal matrix. That's it. Okay? If it is an upper diagonal matrix or lower diagonal matrix, generally call that matrix as a triangle matrix. And next is finally equal matrix. If a matrix is said to be equal, when the matrix are said to be equal, the order of the matrix has to be equal. Okay, first thing is both A, here consider A matrix, A is of Aij, inverse N, B is equal to Bij, inverse N. First, both A and B are of same order. The first condition to say two matrices are equal, the order should be equal. Okay, so I have taken N cross N, it might be of 2 cross 2 also. See, I am going to just take an example. That is, here I am going to take X, Y, Z and U. Okay, so this is my A matrix and I am going to take another matrix B, which is of minus 1, root 3, 4, 2. Yeah, I'll just take pi also. Okay, so this is another matrix. See, this, the order of this is 2 cross 2, that is 2 by 2. And here the order of this matrix is also 2 by 2. See, if Aij is equal to Bij for every I and j. So the second condition is here we can say x is equal to minus 1. Okay, and that is y is equal to root 3. And z is equal to 4. And u is equal to pi. And this is the condition for the equal matrix. It means the elements can be related to the corresponding places. Okay. So and this is example for a equal matrix. So in this class we have learned about what is matrix, general form of a matrix, and types of the matrix. And next we'll see the basic operations involved.